Hey guys, back for another video. Not that long this time. It's only been a couple weeks since my last one. Hope everyone's doing good. Sunday morning here, just hanging out, chilling, listening to some records. Just woke up, felt like making a video. A lot of these I actually picked up a long time ago, so not, you know, relatively long ago, considering how much I picked up recently, but. Probably seen me post most, if not all, of these in during the Facebook group, so probably won't be a surprise, but still really happy to fill out all of these holes. Great stuff. Crossing stuff off the want list. Been having really good luck with that, so let's just get into it. First up, Benny Maupin, Lotus and Jewel. One I never had on wax, so really happy to have this from 1974 on ECM. You guys probably know this. If you don't, just fantastic. His debut record, fantastic spiritual, moto, post-bop. Kind of structured, improvising, definitely ethereal. This record makes a great use of a space, for sure, giving everyone enough room. Definitely bring together musicians from some different backgrounds you got. Aside from Maupin, you have Herbie Mann, Buster Williams, Freddie Waits, Billy Hart, Bill Summers, and Charles Sullivan, so amazing lineup there. Just go listen to it. Never heard it. It's a masterpiece, in my opinion. So definitely one of my favorite on ECM, for sure. Next up here, we have a couple from ESP. Haven't picked up much ESP records recently, so happy to have both of these from the same player. So we got Sonny Simmons, Staying on the Watch from 66. Kind of a dense, kind of intense free jazz session. I think this fit in on ESP very, very well. So Teddy Smith on bass, John Hicks on piano, Marvin Patillo on percussion, Barbara Donald on trumpet, and then Simmons on sax. I don't know if I showed you, the back, but it's the same. Always love the artwork on these ESP, especially the back. They're kind of checkered, classic checkered artwork with the different albums they're putting out at the time. But yeah, kind of a well-known cover. You've probably seen this posted around quite a bit, but fantastic free jazz. Fits in quite well on ESP, I think. And then another one, I believe was from the same year, from 66. This is Sonny Simmons' Music from the Spheres, I think it is. So, once again, Barbara Donald on trumpet, who anytime they're together, they make amazing, amazing stuff. Mike Cohen on piano, Zuni Booth on bass, Jim Zetro on drums, and Burt Wilson plays on one track, sax, Delphi's Days. So four tracks, two tracks on each side. Great stuff though. Love that lettering up there. I believe he actually married that Barbara Donald later on, so there's a label. Really awesome. Kind of this one's a lot more structured, modal, say at times. Even though he's great as an improviser, kind of a bit different from the his previous record I just showed. I believe this was the first record that of his that was on ESP disc. I could be wrong about that, but I'm pretty sure that was the case. I think that was the case actually, but great stuff nonetheless. It's free, you know, but it's not crazy. It's, like I said, free at times, but definitely more structured and then avant-garde, improvised. Still out there, but not as much as the other one, I would say. It's great stuff. Sonny Simmons, happy to have both of those off the list. Here, a record that I know Tony loves. I love this player, champions this record a lot. This is Noah Howard, The Black Ark. And I have to agree, this is fantastic. I've heard it plenty of times before I actually got it. So, great stuff from 1972. Originally released on Freedom. This is the German pressing on Spiegel, also from 72. On the Egg label there, as you can see. I know you guys have probably seen that label before, but there you go. Fantastic free jazz. The gatefold was just opened on me. There you go. That. I got this at a good price. It was sealed. So I kind of was wanting to hold out for a UK original, but this is just as good, in my opinion. Concerning it was sealed, and they got it for such a good price, I couldn't pass it up. So Arthur Doyle plays on this. I know I've talked about him before. I know not everyone kind of agrees with his playing or is into him. It's intense, crazy, kind of out there. I love his playing. And then to kind of balance it out, tone it down, you have Earl Cross on this as well. He says more toned down, but definitely not in a boring sense at all. Then, let's see, I still have, so Noah Howard on sax, Arthur Doyle on sax, alto and tenor, respectively, and then Earl Cross on trumpet, Leslie Waldron on piano, then Norris Jones, Cerrone on bass, and then to round it out, Muhammad Ali on drums. Who Cerrone and Muhammad Ali on drums, kind of, and then you have someone called Yuma on congas as well. Yeah, but Cerrone and Muhammad Ali definitely give off a kind of an Afro vibe from the rhythm section. Drums and bass definitely give me that kind of feel. And then plus the kind of crazy free jazz playing from the trumpet section, the horn sections. Makes this an amazing record, so definitely high recommendation as well. And this one. Great, great stuff. Next up here, we have a Private Press free jazz record out of Massachusetts. This is a quartet. I believe we have James Cox, Tony DeSico, Casey Jones, and Libya Johnson. So it's sax, bass, drums, guitar, and vocals. Cool artwork there. I was like, artwork. Yeah, plain label. Just free jazz. Really, really cheap though. Definitely worth picking up. This is from 1980, I believe. I'll try to leave a sample. I'm not sure if this is uploaded online or not, but if it is, definitely leave a sample. If you see it, pick it up. It should be only a couple bucks, so I think I got this for like $4 or $5. This is, if you can hear it, this is a record that we're listening to background. Not sure if you can hear it. I've been hunting anything from these guys for a while.
To the belly and the kidneys.
Yeah, so Arika Audition. This is the pink cover, obviously, as you can see. There's a brown cover, the same name, the same title and name, just different music, obviously. If you guys know, if you guys don't know anything about the group or what this is. Basically, the Arika Institute was a, I guess, kind of an education center, kind of more for teaching science and human development, stuff like that, from what I understand. And the members decided to make some music, a couple records. So as you can hear, it's like basically psychedelic, psych spiritual jazz, in a sense. I don't know how else to describe it. Just everything kind of mixing together, drony at times, definitely meditative. So you got the spoken word, like kind of instructions for meditation, and then, but it's avant, psych, like I said, spiritual, spacing, everything. So I don't know if I showed the label or not. Oh yeah, I think I did, but anyway, plain white label. The cover is a bit beat on this when I got it, so I got it for a decent price, but the records are in great, great shape. Played fine, so had to grab it when I saw it. Definitely still after the other one. Kind of interesting story behind this. Don't really know who actually plays in the group. Like, it's the Arika Institute musicians, but it doesn't say, like, they're the members, but it doesn't say actually who they are, their names, so I think it's still kind of unknown to this day who the actual members were, but great music, regardless. Like I said, definitely after the other one as well, so happy to have crossed this one off my list. And same thing with this, another one. Karen, I know me and you talked about this quite a bit, so sorry I couldn't find you one, but Bill Lewis and Conjamal, The River, from 78 on Philly Jazz. Great, great, kind of spiritual jazz. It's a duet. Just Bill Lewis on vibes, vibraphone, and Conjamal on marimba. There they are.
chilling.
Hanging out. Yeah, fantastic. Definitely. So the says the music on this album is called jazz or black classical music or the new music or avant-garde. The name is not important. It is grassroots, the music of the people. I feel that it tells the story of the struggle of all people. In dealing with music, one must remember that there is more to music than what the eyes or ears can perceive. I totally agree. That's Bill Lewis. Peace, Bill Lewis. And then Kanji Mall says, As Salim means peace. Dedicated to Rashid Salim, also a vibist and percussionist who works with bands like Sun Ra and Khan. So, really cool. Definitely highly recommended once again. Happy to have that. Next up here, more free jazz. Billy Bang's Survival Ensemble, New York Collage. College? It's a New York Collage on here, but on the label it says New York College. So, anyway, 78, New York Loft Jazz from that scene. Excellent, excellent session. Free jazz session. No business that label from Lithuania put out an unreleased session from these guys. I think it was from a year before or after this one, but fantastic. Same players, basically, so you have Billy Bang on violin and little hand instruments, percussion. He also does poetry on here as well. Balal Abdur Rahman, who plays on that East Ensemble, the New York record, if you're familiar with that. Plays tenor, soprano, sax on here, bullhorn, percussion. Henry Warner on sax, also percussion. And then William Parker on bass, Rashid Barker on drums, and Kuana Fuller on congas. And what's cool about this copy was that it was actually signed with a dedication from Billy Bang. So I hope you guys could see that, but that's cool. Yeah, great, great stuff. Definitely if you're into that free jazz New York loft scene, definitely one to check out. This one and the one that came out on No Business. I think it came out 2013 or, I don't know, a few years back, but really cool. Donald Byrd, not too crazy into Donald Byrd anymore. I was really into him when I first started collecting and getting into jazz heavy, but one I did never had from him, never found on wax, so happy to have this one. This is Donald Byrd's Ethiopian Nights from 72 on Blue Note. Just funky jazz, I imagine. But one of his best records, in my opinion, one of my favorites from him. This is on the United Artists label, which I think is the first pressing of this, so really cool. Finally have that, yeah, cross that off my list. I'm getting away from the jazz for a minute. It's gonna be a slight minute, but just a minute. We have Magma, the first record, I believe just self-titled Magma from 1970 on Philips. The gatefold, sorry, kind of an awkward gatefold because it goes like that. It has these flaps over here where the records are in. So, yeah, it has the credits on the flaps, so. Not back, that's just a, that, but I love the artwork on this. You guys might have seen this posted in the group before. Yeah, their debut album, fantastic jazz rock, prog, Zool, I believe it's called as well. I love these guys' first two records, this one and the second one. They kind of lost me on the third one with the vocals. I know they made up like their own language for these records, but it's really cool. I love that they did that. But yeah, they kind of lost me with that. I just couldn't get into the vocals. I know it's a classic record, and I don't dispute that. I just, yeah, vocals weren't doing it for me on that one. So I was a big fan of the first two. So don't have the second one. Happy to add this one. I sold my reissue to grab this and a couple other things. So, kind of wild and crazy times, more out there. And then definitely more laid back as well. So kind of varies all over the place. But jazz rock, prog, so you guys probably know what that one is. If you don't, go check it out. That's the kind of rock that I'm, I guess, into as opposed to, if you're curious about listening to anything else other than jazz. Stuff like that. If three guys that don't know me too well. What do we have for time? 15 minutes? Not too bad. Next up, vibraphonist. I like vibraphonist if you don't. I love the vibes, that instrument. I'm a big fan, so if you haven't noticed by now, but this is Carl Berger. With his record, We Are You. Wait. Yeah, We Are You on Kalig, which is a German label. This is a German pressing. Kind of a cool looking label, pretty simple, but. So it's kind of a vibes and piano led free jazz session. The bit of vocal work from his wife at the time, Ingrid Berger, who does vocals and percussion on this. Carl Berger plays vibes, piano, and marimba. Alan Blairman on drums and percussion, and Peter Kold on bass. Peter Kold was all over the German record, so really cool. But yeah, like I said, piano vibes led free jazz. Nothing too crazy. Amazing must have. Not really a must have record, but still really, really solid in my opinion. I really like Carl Berger, so big fan of vibes. There's one record specifically I'm after from him. I think it's called Tuned In. I think it's called Tuned In. So I would love to find that. I picked up a Coltrane I did not have. I had the reissue of this, but ended up selling it for a earlier pressing. Not an original, but Meditations by John Coltrane. This is on the red and black label.
Feel it in your ears.
That one. So this is kind of around the time when Coltrane is turning into free jazz, more free out there, the new thing. You know, it's got the classic quartet on here. Except he added Rashid Ali on this, who I think after this album replaced Elvin Jones for good. And then he also added Pharoah Sanders on this one as well. So, you know, can't go wrong with Pharoah. A dense, spiritual kind of mode of free jazz. You guys probably know. Just another one cross off the list. In case you're wondering if I do have a list, yes, I do actually have a list that I made up. Not for stuff like this, but just for some of the more rare, harder to find records, I do have an actual list, and I cross stuff off, keep it in a Word document, so. So this guy's, I never see his records hardly ever around here, except for online, so if they do come up, I have to grab them. Billy Harper's The Awakening. Fantastic. Japanese pressing, I believe, as most of his stuff is. This one is from 78, maybe? On Marge. No, it's on the Marge label. 79, sorry, 79. Spiritual and jazz modal. A lot of world influences. Kind of definitely strong, I think, Asian, Eastern influences on here. Stuff like that, but. Yeah, if you guys don't know Billy Harper, you don't know this record, I think this is a good one to start with. Not too out there, more spiritual modal than free, I would say.
Women?
Yeah, as usual, I'm not going to spend too long on each record going into it, because if you're really interested, go check them out yourself, you know. Don Cherry. Once again, another one that I've been after for a while now, a few years. Untitled Gift. So, you have, I'm sorry, this is Billy Bang, not Don Cherry. It's Don Cherry with Billy Bang, Wilbur Morris, and Dennis Charles. I don't know why I said Don Cherry. Billy Bang, Untitled Gift. From 1982, once again, on Anima Records, same as the previous Billy Bang that I showed. There's the label to that one. Not too crazy on the artwork there, but a fantastic avant-garde free session. I think you have to be into jazz violin to be into Billy Bang at all. If you don't care for that sound of the violin, jazz violin, you're not gonna like this, but I think this is fantastic. Great, great stuff. Yeah, so definitely check it out. Dennis Charles actually, does pretty good on this. I think he kind of stands out in a way. Kind of a very intense, playing from your time. Nice energetic group improvisation, especially on the track, what is it, Levitation for Santana? Fantastic, fantastic. That really stood out to me too, so. So Billy Bang's Untitled Gift. And then to probably round it out here, oh no, let's go with a few more to show, sorry. Sorry to keep you, a few more to show. Just take this out and everything in my crate's falling over. All right, so Jamil Moondock with Moontoo, or Jamil Moondock Moontoo, it's always one name. The Intrepid live in Poland. So you know how I am, I'm up to Polish jazz. This isn't a Polish artist, but it is live in Poland on a Polish label, so I have to grab it. Jamil Moondock, I'm still not sure how it's pronounced correctly. It's a fantastic, fantastic, free jazz record. I'm sure this is a later one from the 80s. It's from 81. Just two tracks. First track, Blues for Katie, and then the second track, First Feeding, which actually has a record called First Feeding. I believe it's his first record, which I would love to find. So you have Jamil Moondock, Roy Campbell, William Parker, Rashid Baker. Kind of flimsy Polish cover as always, but
is going out and filling the entire world.
Yeah, but great stuff. So if you can hear it in the background, maybe you kind of get a sense for what this is like. It varies a bit more jazzy about now, but Strata East. Always happy to cross this off my list. These off my list. Larry Ridley with Some of the Parts. Excuse me. I always see this, always ends up going for crazy money, so happy to have got one for not so, not so crazy amount. Very clean copy, too. Very clean copy. Funky, really funky. Spiritual times, but definitely more funky than anything jazz funk. You know, most of those Strata records have that spiritual-esque vibe on them, but this one really stood out to me. Unfortunately, a lot of his other records that he's on aren't always like this, or not this funky, or this good, in my opinion, but usually he's a sideman, too, so I don't know how many records he's a leader on, but I know this is my favorite I've heard so far, so. All right, just a few more here. Another ECM, Robin Kenyatta, Girl from Martinique. Kenyatta, as the record ends, so fitting timing. Girl from Martinique, another fantastic free jazz avant-garde spiritual record. World music, you guys probably know this, seen this. If you haven't, another ECM that I would highly, highly recommend. This. The other one that I showed, Benny Maupin and Dave Holland. The Dave Holland record are probably my favorites on that label. It's called Birds, something, Wind of Birds or something like that, but I can't remember it right now. But if I had to pick, these are definitely my favorite on the label for sure. So 20 minutes, that's about it. I guess I could show this one too. So still not sure how I feel about this record here. So this is Milton Nascimento and Son Imaginarium, which is like his backing band on this. Name of the record is right there. I'm not going to try to butcher it. Milagre Dos Pejis. Double LP. And he has another record, which is similar in name. So this is basically the live version of that, although it's not exactly the same album. This is basically takes some tracks from that album, basically the ones that have strings on them, have string arrangements, and then added some of his own classic tracks, his previous classic tracks. And, it's the live show. I feel like kind of he didn't make maybe the best use of, that's not EMI, best use of the band, and because he also had an orchestra. He had a full string orchestra, horn orchestra, I think it was like a 30-member orchestra or something. I feel like he could have made more use of the orchestra. Maybe it's just me, I don't know. From the reviews I've read, because I did read a little bit about it after I listened to this a few times, I wasn't like crazy about it, just to see what other people thought. And like, I guess the reviews were really, really good from that night that people were actually at the show, so maybe it's just me. And I need to spin it more. I know I showed the instant side, but just to show some more photos. Sorry about the glare. But yeah, not loving this one. Kind of slow at times. I don't think it fully maybe translated from the show to record. Maybe, like I said, maybe it's just me. I don't know. But original Brazilian pressing from 74. So this is probably going to be up for trade or sale if anyone's interested. Although, I don't know why I'm even mentioning it because it might be gone. But just in case I still have it, if anyone's interested, let me know. All right, guys, that's it. Taking up enough of your time. 25 minutes. I rambled more than I should have. Talk to you guys later. Have a good week, and I'll see you soon. Peace.